about breaking down what you know, what you think you know, into components that will work for you. If you have a better definition of money, I'm expecting it to put more money in your pocket, right? Whereas a worse definition might be the reason why money keeps leaking out. Wow. So what you're telling me is that you guys are good at getting money. But if you come into my class tonight and you raise your hand and say you could use more money, you're also telling me that you suck at keeping it. We can say, no, it's okay for you to love money. It's okay for you to have as much money as you want. Just stay away from money. So, well, how do you get money if you don't get it from me? I mean, come on, this guy here. Now, I know you guys are hard workers. I know you guys even know stuff. You guys each know stuff I don't know. But seriously, if even this guy here shows up every week, doesn't work, but he just shows up here because I'm a sweet, compassionate, rich guy. And he just comes every day, and because he says what it tells me what I want to hear, you know, what I do, I just start giving him money.
Well, give me some.
Now, how exactly is he going to feel about himself? Is he building any self-esteem, or is he really just...
Of course
you are.
Because I'm smarter than you, because you're the one giving me the money.
So let me ask you this. Do you think he wants to be my bitch for the next 5 years? Okay, so let's break that down again. Is money the root of all evil?
No.
Love of money? No, the verse says, the love of money is the root of all evil, for while some coveted after. What does covetousness mean? That means mine's off limits, find your own.
Right?
I'm for master money, by the way. Right off, no, I'm just kidding. Now, find your own, okay? So here is the problem. We've got a bunch of people raised in this country going to church and Sunday school for what is a noble endeavor and a great education, and they're trying to build a financial life off half a verse. And the half a verse is in conflict with their work life, with their responsible financial life. Right? You know you need money, you know it's the right thing to do to take care of your family, you know it's the right thing to do to be honorable to your employer. And yet, on the inside, you got this other voice that said, it's the root of all evil, it's the root of all evil. These guys, you invite them to your church, right? You got this kicking church, it's great, you got this, you know, great preacher, whatever. Here's what I've noticed is happening. Even if these guys invite me to church, here's what happens. The guy comes up front there who's supposed to be able to teach us what we don't know about the Bible. But I find in churches even, we come to church not to learn, we come to kind of agree, right? We say amen, right? They say something, amen. Amen, right? Amen means so be it. We're just really agreeing and agreeing and agreeing. And I think that practice of just coming places to agree messes us up, because when he says something, he or she says something that we haven't heard before or disagree with, we don't know what to do. He says something I haven't heard before or I disagree with, I don't say, oh, wow, thank you for teaching me. I say, I'm out of here. And on the way out, I'm never going to talk to you guys again. On the way out, I just say, I'm not listening to that. You know, I just do my mumbling thing, right? And I walk out and I just say, excuse me, push it! Right? So guys, one of the biggest obstacles right now we have to overcome, just because we're men in America, is our habit of being critics. That we don't come to learn anything new. We come really to find out how much of what we know he knows. And so what do? Every time you say something, it's going to be, I got to challenge it. I got to see if he knows what I know. Well, I don't need to. God, if I knew everything he knew, guess where I'd be? And our beliefs, we have this whole idea of criticizing, and I need to show you the model where you have to actively overcome yourself so that you can overcome everything else in life. But if you can't overcome you, if you can't keep your own mouth shut, if you can't, right? If you can't control your own tongue, read the book of James, or tell him if you see him again, read the book of James over and over again. Oh, there's another part. And then do the frickin' book of James, right? Right? No, that's how we become critics, right? We read a bunch and don't do any of what we read. Do you get to the next job, you get just so far, then all of a sudden, fired again. And so you start over again, and you're going back, you get to that same spot. And you do the same thing, and you end up in the same position again. Get a new relationship, you can only go so far. And then you do the same thing again, and you go always back to square one. Guys, that's not the way to live a life, but it's the way most people end up living, because they don't understand how it works. And so I learned this habit at the very end of working with the homeless. I learned it because when my second wife left, it was 4 years to the day, our anniversary, at 4 a.m, I heard the sound of a diesel truck, and I looked outside, and there was the big truck with the horse trailer and our horses, and she was driving off to Wyoming to be with sister. You know, it says a lot about you when your wife leaves you for a horse. But anyway, words and got this book by Viktor Frankl. Viktor Frankl, the story interested me because he was an Austrian psychiatrist later, but he started off as a medical doctor in Austria in the 1930s when Hitler invaded Austria. And the problem was, Viktor Frankl was Jewish. And if you were Jewish and Hitler showed up, you were off to the concentration camps. Slow death. So was his wife, his kids, his parents. But the difference between Viktor Frankl and the others is that Viktor Frankl had a life on the other side of all of this suffering for 40 years as the eminent psychologist Viktor Frankl, who founded the third Viennese school of psychotherapy called logotherapy. Meaning, that if you could just find a meaning to your life, or even a meaning for this suffering, right? See, guys, if I give you this formula and I say, hey, to get on top, I just need you to act like a student for a while. I need you to look for experts. And I just need you to do their exercise. Can you do that over time? See, it's going to suck for 6 months, right? But you have a meaning for the suckage. Got it? What's really horrible is when you're suffering. I'm more than a plane. More than some pretty face beside a train. And it's not easy to be